Hi guys, today in this episode we will play a bit with this Zhiyun. How to pronounce Zhiyun? How?
Zhiyun. So this is the correct pronunciation.
Zhiyun. Why Zhiyun? Zhiyun. 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 Ah. So today we will play a bit with this Zhiyun Crane 2 gimbal system. I want some solution where the camera can follow me, or the camera can follow my ugly face. And I hope it will help a lot, because I still don't have a good cameraman. Just time to time, or on the drone killer. He's coming to my studio and help me a bit on the recordings. And mainly all of these gimbal systems, they are made for SLR or for DSLR cameras. And in this video, we will see how this Crane 2 is fit with a professional mini camcorder. Ah, by the way, guys, I will not do here a full review of this Crane 2, because a lot of other guys did already on YouTube, and they are really nice videos. If I will speak about something, it's mostly about mechanical structure or mechanical noise or something like this. What we find in a box, this is the charger, which has a really neat feature. You can hook up to two USB power source, and then this will charge much more faster the batteries. What I don't understand here, it's why the Zhiyun is not using some kind of really standard AA or AAA batteries, because this is what you have in your light system, this is what you have in your monitor, this is what you have in your microphones, in the wireless transmitters, in the flashes, everywhere. So it's really annoying to now get another kind of charger with the USB input for the other kind of battery. So Zhiyun, please, if you can do, please change the battery system here to the normal AA. Then you get with the Zhiyun Crane 2 this really nice redesigned leg system, which is the TRM02, and this is made exactly for this Crane 2 gimbal. And what I don't like about this one is you cannot turn this screw with the penny, so you have to use some kind of screwdriver if you wanna mount this leg on a specific position on your gimbal grip. The whole mechanical structure of this leg is rock solid. It's like a hammer. Yeah, the gimbal for the first touch, it's a really high quality and really heavy, really industrial kind of feeling. It's definitely not a toy. Just let's check here the bearing on the motor. So here, nothing movement at all. The next motor, let's see. Yeah, it's moving a bit. It's moving about 2 millimeters, but I don't know if it's the distortion of the arm here, or it came from the motor shaft. And the last one is, yeah, it's absolutely rock solid. Very nice touch on the details. They installed here a scale, which is a metric base, I think. Yeah, it's absolutely metric, it looks to me. And it's carved in with some kind of laser, or I don't know, with the CNC. And this is true also here on this scale. And the last one is on the base plate itself. Here on a side you have this scale, and on a both of the side, really nice touch. And on a bottom, no, this one is just painted on a surface, so this will be wear out a bit. Yeah, really nice machining everywhere. Yeah, definitely they paid a lot of attention on our details. For example, here on this lens support plate, you get a really nice copper washers, and both of this fastener, it's this ratchet type. Let me show you. So After when you tied it up, you can move away, and everything is made from metal. And here you can see a kind of T-slot, something like this, maybe you can see. So this T-slot is supporting this plate to move parallel on both of the sides. There is a kind of wibbly bobbly on the end. Let me compare to the original Manfrotto toe base plate. And I have from this Manfrotto base plates a short version, a long version, a much more longer version. And I always left them on my cameras. The width of the Zhiyun, it's about 50 millimeter. It's just 2/10 under. And I think the Manfrotto will be a bit smaller, just a tiny bit. And the height from the plate bottom and between the top, it's about 10 and a half. And on a Manfrotto, 10.7. So again, this magical 2/10. This rubber here, it's much more, it's much more stickier than the Manfrotto. Yeah, it looks to me much more precise. So let's see what will happen if I use the Manfrotto base plate on the crane too. Yeah, really nice. Really nice, absolutely nice. And then we can tie them up on a side and to lock it absolutely. Yeah, rock solid, rock solid. I really like it. And even it can turn with this really big Manfrotto base plate. Maybe you can see. I still have here 1.5 centimeter. I think this will work. I think it's a bit a joke. They did this scale, on the base plate, but they forgot to put here some kind of mark. Nothing. So, you have a scale, but you don't have the counter parts on the fixed element. Really funny. Let's go to this focus dial. Oh, guys, you have to feel this. It's just art of the precision. And the feeling is absolutely right. So no wobbly bobbly at all to the side and really well machined. I think, we can replace it. Oh, really nice. So I think I will machine here some kind of wood or brush ring around it. I think if they do this a bit bigger, then it will be okay. But the buttons are absolutely recognizable. The record button, it have some kind of indentation. I suggest to the Zhiyun to make this one positive, not negative, because then it will be much more easier to feel where is the record button. And this joystick, it's... Oh, this is really nice. I really like it. This one is the new OLED display. Really tiny, really small. You know, overall, guys, this is absolutely a beast. This is absolutely a professional gear. And this small box, it's a different set of cables for different purposes. This one is for charging the batteries. This one is for Sony, Panasonic, Canon, for Canon. So it's really ridiculous, the whole camera and video industry, how they are stupid. I don't know why they not choose one common solution to control your camera and your lenses. It's just ridiculous. We have a Manfrotto plate, we have here a lot of different small accessories for the installation. I don't know what we will use and why we will use, but definitely I have here a bunch of small tricky items. I find a lot of hidden features on this gimbal. So let me show you. You see this? Oh, look at this. Beautiful. I really like it. Why? Because, for example, on this way, I can mount my tiny, 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 tiny Sony action cam on this base plate like this. Yeah? Very nice touch. Oh, I really like it. I find the other one in other place. It's here. Eh? Eh? You can imagine, here is the camera. And here you can mount whatever you want to mount. Lights, microphone, monitor, whatever. Here is other one, and here is the next one. And we also have here one, and we also have two on a bottom. Mostly I like this position here, because this is absolutely perfect for heavy and big and professional camera setups. What we will do now, we will take off my Sony camcorder from the top of my head, and we will make here the Sony PXW X70 camcorder setup with Zhiyun Crane 2 gimbal. First time in my life to use a DSLR camera as a video camera. Sorry guys, if something is not good, yeah, it's so clunky for me. This is my standard camcorder setup, and this grip together with the professional microphone inputs. Here is my wireless transmitter, and time to time I also installing here video light into this cold shoe. And on this side, I have the additional shotgun mic mount system. This is also really heavy piece of metal. And I'm using now at the moment the standard battery, which is the VFP70. But I have other one, which is the VFP100. So altogether, this setup is really heavy. So I'm not sure we can use all of these professional fixtures on a top with the wireless transmitter. I don't know. It looks to me it will not work together with this one. It's not a big deal, because then I can hook up to my field recorder and then everything is solved. So where is this really small dot here? This is my center point. Actually, this is pretty easy. You just have to unscrew this mounting screws, and then that's it. The whole assembly is came off together. So now we have a normal size of camera camcorder with professional features. So let's start the process. I think I have to find the new center point of the weight, and this is really simple. You just have to place some kind of stick or rolling element or even a pencil to your table, and then you have to place your camera on top of it, and then check where is your new center point. And so now I think my center point is moved back a bit. Yeah, it looks to me kind of working. So let's push it until, first issue. Yeah, I think I have to move the plate more backward even. So the problem here now is this pin is too far, and it's just simply not locking. Okay, now it's locking. So now my camera, my camcorder, it's tilting to the back, so I have to move the camera forward a bit, and this is what I can't do. So yeah, we arrived to some kind of problem. So I think I cannot use the Zhiyun plate for this camera, because I cannot move the camera more forward. I think I will use the Manfrotto toe plate. Eh? Okay. So let me hold this one here. Yeah, guys, almost perfect, almost perfect. And now is the time to adjust this one. Perfect. So now let's balance this one. Perfect. Perfect. Okay, let's see if the viewfinder it can turn. Really nice. I just have there 1 or 2 millimeter. Now is the time to adjust this one. I don't know how. Ah, for that I have to do like this. Okay, this is now it's absolutely front heavy, so I have to push back. Yeah, I think it's nice. Good. Let me do some crazy movements. Absolutely, now it's balanced. So let's put it back to the stand. And if we did a good job then, it doesn't matter where we are rotating the camera, the stand, you know, don't wanna move at all. That is a drawback, guys, if you are using the Sony X70 camera. The center of your lens is not on the center of your rotation, so it can do this wibbly-wobbly vertical distortion in your record. You see the lens is going up and down. I think with a bit more work I can balance out the system exactly on a way when the center point of this rotation, yeah, so this axis will be absolutely matching with the center point of the lens. Yeah, maybe you can see like this. Yeah, so the selfie is working. 1, 2, 3. Go back. And let me connect this camera control cable to my camcorder, and I hope we will see something. My camcorder, I think, oh, there is some kind of computer or something, and he wanna access the memory card, so I don't know. And nothing is changing, and even I cannot start the record. No. At the moment, this camera, it's not accepting any kind of control signal, which is came from the crane too. And this is really bizarre because this is a professional level of camera. I don't know what's going on here. Maybe the guys in Zhiyun, they have to work a bit on the firmware of the crane too, because I think I'm not alone who wanna use the crane too with camcorders. Guys, the menu system, it's really awful because here we have this dial, yeah? And then on the middle we have this OK button or Enter button or whatever. So I have to press the menu, yeah? I press the menu. I can step in a menu, but I cannot use the middle button to confirm. Oh my God. So how? Joystick. So now I have to press the right. Okay, so right back. It's really confusing. And you see, nothing. And then I have to press right. And now if I press the menu, it's coming back. This is also back. So it's really annoying. Nothing. No, nothing. So focus is not working. And I don't know what this dial actually is doing now. So no focus, no zoom, and even it cannot start the recording. Now I have to use my Sony remote controller or the Sony application in my phone. This crane too cannot control my professional camcorder. And this is really, really annoying. So I have to contact with the Zhiyun company and ask them what's going on here. But hey, this is not a big deal because fortunately I have this other Sony R7 Mark II camera, so I can use this gimbal with these extra features. Okay, but now let's move forward with my workflow, because the original idea is to use this crane too, to follow my ugly face. So now I'm installing this Zoom Play. Ah, beautiful. Yeah, I just have a really limited amount of light now. Hopefully you can see everything on YouTube. I have to practice a lot with this application, but it's kind of nice. It's really smooth. Yeah, but what I don't like about this one, if I'm going back now to the locking mode like this, and look what's going on. Oh my God. Look at this. Everything is shaking. Help! Okay. The guys in the Xeon, they need to do something with the firmware. Yeah? Or maybe I have to play with the motor force and with the sensitivity. I don't know. It's the best time to install my iPhone into this iPhone holder or phone holder, and then maybe, just maybe, we can use my phone to track objects, yeah? So, and now I will mount this one on top of my camcorder with this puppy here. And I think we need to balance again. Yeah, of course, we need to balance again everything. Please connect the device. Which device? Oh, man. I think I lost the patient. Yeah, I don't care. Application mode, phone camera again, confirm. So let me start the recording. So now if I'm moving my camera, yeah, I think it's kind of working. So, okay, he find it again. Mm-hmm. Okay, so this idea is working. Let's solve the face tracking issue with other software, which is the Xeon Assistant, yeah? Okay, here is my face. Okay, he find me. Yay! I still have a feeling I have to modify a few settings in this application, or maybe in the Crane 2 itself, because maybe you can see, but now he's moving really rapidly, so I don't know what's going on here. I have to practice a bit with this. Ta-da! We are done. So let me do some kind of test. So now I will walk to my mixer desk, yeah, which is here. Beautiful. I really like it. Oh, guys, this is this is something really fantastic. Beautiful. So now I think is the best time to go outside and shoot something outside with this face tracking option. But for that I have to pick up my other camera, the tripod, the camera, the crane too. Okay, guys, I cannot switch on the face autofocus detection on my Sony camcorder. I don't know the reason for why. Maybe I choose the really wrong skin setup. But as you can see, the Xeon Crane 2 is give you a lot of possibility if you are kind of YouTube vlogger or whatever, or even if you're working for some kind of TV station as an independent documentary video guy or something, this is a really useful feature. You even don't need a cameraman. You can walk in front of the camera, you can speak freely, you can show the things. You just have to keep in your mind, you always have to watch into the camera or into the iPhone or to your Android phone, and then this Crane 2 will do the job for you. Beautiful. I really like it. I hope the Xeon Tech will update soon the firmware of this gimbal to make sure we camcorder guys, we also can use all of these advanced functions like control the focus, control the zoom, and control the camera, the recording button. This is really, really basic. At least, guys, in a Xeon Tech, please give us the possibility to control the recording, yeah? So, because now it's not working. I don't know the reason. And yeah, guys, I think we are done with this video at the moment. Guys, this is insane. A really heavy camcorder, it's following me. And it's everything just working smoothly and perfectly. Look at this, look at this. Unbelievable. Oh my God. Ah, I forgot to show you guys something, but this will be in the next video, eh? I also purchased a dual handle for this Xeon Crane 2, but not the original Xeon one. It's something else, and this is much more sophisticated than the original Xeon. And in the next video, you will see why. Oh my God, the beauty of machining and precision. Ah, and it's much more cheaper than the original one, eh? I hope you guys enjoyed. See you next time. Bye.